This is a new, squishy simulation technique, and it's a bit like teaching a pile of jello how to win an Olympic gold medal in gymnastics.
Remember the triple tuck and the dismount.
Yes. So, what if a desk clamp could learn gymnastics? You know, jump, twist, stick the landing, all with real physics. That is really hard. Why? Well, you see, most characters you meet in video games have a bone and joint structure which determines how they can move around. But jellyfish, worms, or a stress ball don't have skeletons. They move by squishing, stretching, and contracting their own soft bodies. To animate that, you need to figure out a series of muscle contractions and relaxations that make physical sense. Simulating that is brutally hard. Thousands of interacting parts, collisions, friction, and no need closed form equations. So much so that old gradient descent based methods with the blue and orange lines fail to launch this ball into the hoop. Now, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, because this new method can do it every single time. And the results are wild! Starfish can now crawl realistically, gummy caterpillars wriggle forward with incredible realism. Lambs are doing backflips on trampolines, even chess pieces can hop around across the board. Or, if you are in a library, you can also have a little personal butler. I absolutely love this one. Amazing. This level of control was simply not possible with older, first-order methods like gradient descent. But that's not even the best part. I'll show that to you in a moment. So, how is all this insanity even possible? And how long does it take to compute? Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai-Fehér. Dr. Carol, imagine you are hiking in fog. Gradient descent is feeling the local slope with your boots and taking cautious steps. But Newton's method is different. It not only feels the slope, it also senses how the ground curves. So, instead of stepping, it can leap to the right spot much quicker. The trick here is, how do we measure that curvature quickly and accurately in a challenging soft body world with contacts and friction? And in this paper, scientists fuse two superpowers together: automatic differentiation for precise slopes and a clever complex numbers probe that sneaks a microscopic step into an imaginary direction to read curvature cleanly. Crazy mad science. I love it. They call it mixed second-order differentiation, which gives you the information needed for true Newton updates. So now, the optimizer has a map and a compass, not just a feeling underfoot. And now, here is the best part, my favorite experiment. Oh yes, it is not hard to see that soon, even computer games based on this kind of physics will be possible. Man, I cannot wait to see and play that. But based on my calculations, this still takes quite a while to compute. 10 to 25 minutes for 1 second of movement are typical. So, not real time yet, but absolutely within reach for movies and 2 more papers down the line, probably video games. And don't forget, this makes the impossible now possible. Now, we only need to make it faster for games. And man, I cannot wait to see and play that. And here is the other best part. The paper is not from Disney, so I can even talk about it. And with this amazing paper, we are witnessing the birth of a new kind of animation, where soft, squishy worlds are no longer puppeteered, but are truly moving realistically. This isn't just eye candy, it's a glimpse of creatures that move with the richness of real life. Absolutely brilliant! What a time to be alive! And once again, a paper that almost nobody is talking about. You can likely only hear about it here on 2-Minute Papers. So please, don't forget to like and leave a kind comment, so YouTube starts recommending this kind of content, because otherwise, unfortunately, it does not do that. We need new tools for the era of LLMs, and Weights and Biases now has Weave, a lightweight toolkit to confidently iterate on LLM applications. Use traces to debug how data flows through each step of your app, and use evaluations to measure your progress. It is the best. Try it out now at wnb.me/papers or click the link in the description below.